got little colors, too.
That looks like the carpet in my, actually, in your den.
My den? Wait a minute.
Oh, boy.
No chance. That's what you got.
The boss is here.
Chicago, let's show a little respect to the chairman around here, the boss.
Well, maybe not.
I'm ready for Piper's pit. I'm all set for Piper's pit. What's Mr. McMahon doing here?
Well, call Mr. McMahon, owns the joint. He can do whatever the hell he wants.
The Piper's Pits, I suppose, that people remember the most is Jimmy Snuka.
You want bananas? You want bananas? We got bananas. What do you want? You want coconuts? Here I went. I got the coconuts. Here we go. You want bananas? I'll have yourself a banana. Oh, this is what you want. You want to talk? You ain't saying nothing.
As I'm doing this, I'm taking the bananas out. And I said, to make you feel comfortable.
Am I making fun of you? Oh, no, sir. No, sir. No, sir.
I just reared back and I just let it go, and that coconut just went boom! And Jimmy went back and the set went down. And
have a banana! Have a banana! Have a banana! Come on and get him!
Well, I've got a big smile on my face here tonight, and why not? Why not? Because it was just 1 week ago when I guess you'd have to say I permanently terminated Hulkamania. Matter of fact, I think you'd have to say I gave Hulkamania a lethal dose of leprosy. And I said before, I'm gonna honor my contract with Hogan. Yes, I will. I'll pay him every nickel he's got coming to him to stay at home. It's worth it to a man like me to keep Hogan at home. And each day Hogan stays at home, each day Hogan's flesh begins to rot from his decrepit bones. By the time Hulk Hogan's WWE contract has expired, Hogan will be so old, he'll be confined to a wheelchair. Not to worry. I'll make sure there's a great big reservoir bag underneath the wheelchair just to collect his bodily waste. So indeed, I, Vince McMahon, have permanently shelved Hulkamania. But in doing so, not on that same shelf, but just across on the other side in the same closet, though, there was something else I decided to pull off the shelf. Yet another one of my creations. Just as Hulkamania was one of my creations, so too is this. I'm about to pull off the shelf, blow the dust off of it, and present it to you. So here, ladies and gentlemen, some 14 years later, yet another one of my creations, the star of Piper's Pit, ladies and gentlemen, Roddy Piper!
Oh, man. You know, he's got that Irish temper, Cole.
Irish temper? What are you talking about, McMahon?
No, Piper.
Piper's from Scotland.
I don't know. I didn't know he was Scottish. All right, well, both men have tempers.
after 14 long years, Piper's Pit is back.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is Hot Rod's special guest, me.
What?
Yeah, Rod. How you doing, man?
You know, you've got very short fingers. You know what women think about that? Let me set something real straight here. Nobody but nobody made Roddy Piper. Nobody but nobody made Piper's Pit except me and my bald and my flesh and had nothing to do with you. Do not play with me.
Have a seat, man. Chill. Easy.
Just stay in front of me here.
I'll give you credit. I mean, I'll give you credit for having something to do with creating Piper's Pit. But seems to me that lately you've created something else. What the hell is this, man? What the hell is that? Is this Piper's Pit or Piper's Punch? The last time I saw a belly that size, Mae Young was 9 months pregnant. And she had a hand. Looks like you're working on twins. Hey, whoa. You guys want to know what's underneath the Scotsman's kilt? In Roddy's case, it's just an overhanging flap. No. Wait a minute. No. I'm just ribbing you here. But I got to say, you look like you've been to hell in a handbasket, man. Look at you. Look horrible. I mean, well, maybe not hell in a handbasket. Maybe hell in a bread basket. Whoa. I know you're thinking, maybe you're thinking about kicking my ass right about now. I know you, okay? So what I'm about to suggest is, whoa, easy now. Don't be thinking about kicking my ass. What about kissing my ass? You see? No, come on. Hey, you know the rules around here. No, there's a club. No. There's a club called the Vince McMahon Kiss My Ass Club. See, the way you played it, I dropped my trowel. You pucker your lips up, and then, well, maybe that's not such a good idea. Because after all,
I'm sorry, I have children.
Well, I'm sorry, but maybe that's not such a good idea because the last time I saw your lips in action this afternoon, they were sucking on a bratwurst.
Is that right? What's the opposite there? Why don't you see if your good childbearing hips can get between the arms there of the chair? And let me tell you what I think about you, oh, great creator of ours. Let me see. This is your life, Vince McMahon. You started off as a little nothing. First thing you did was become a rock and roll promoter, and you went what? Belly up. Yeah. Broke. Yeah. Nada. Nothing. Of course, then again, wait. We got to give him credit. You are tremendous. You know, there was the Bodybuilding Federation. Oh, that was a good one. I'll tell you, that was a good one. You are a creative man, you are. Yeah, nice rug, too. Nice rug there. I'm sorry, must cost thousands. And the shoulders you have in there, the padded shoulders. Why, you're ready to play football now, aren't you? Huh? Oh, yeah. Oh, would that be XFL? Is that it? Oh, that was a big one. That was a big one. So basically, the only job you've been able to hold is the one your daddy gave you.